Hello everyone, welcome to this video lesson. In this video lesson, we would like to talk about PN junction diode in a forward bias and reverse bias. In the previous video lesson, we have explained that PN junction diode is not a sandwich of P and N type material. We will take a pure semiconducting material. Please refer to the previous video for a complete details. Here I am doing only a simple recap of all that. From one side, we'll be start adding a trivalent impurity. Therefore, this side starts becoming a p-type material. From the other side, we start adding a pentavalent impurity. Therefore, that starts becoming a n-type material. This is called a doping, which makes the extrinsic semiconducting material. Therefore, this is going to behave like a p-type with majority of the holes, majority carriers too. N-type with the majority carriers of electrons. As it is explained, this innermost holes are experiencing a high repulsion from the other holes and attraction on the other side. Therefore, they will shift from P side to the other side of a junction. Similarly, this innermost electrons from the N side will shift to the other side because there is a repulsion at home and attraction on the other side. They will further stop the flow of the charges from one side to other side because this new shifted charges oppose the flow of the new charges. Thus, a reverse potential is generated at a junction called something like this part. A reverse potential is generated. In fact, if you see, this starts behaving like a negative plate of a battery, this starts behaving like a positive plate of a battery. A reverse potential is generated, and that reverse potential is called barrier potential. As the charges cannot overcome this barrier potential themselves, there is no flow of the charges, so device behaves like an insulator. To make it passing a current, we shall give a way for these electrons and holes to overcome this barrier potential. That means we shall connect a battery. So battery will give enough energy for the charges to travel from one side to other side. When you connect the battery, there are two ways of connecting a battery. Say for example, you have connected a positive plate of a battery to the p-type material and the negative plate of the battery to the n-type material. From here, positive charges starts. They will come up to here and they are immediately seeing a positive charges. Therefore, this positive charges from the battery with a force, with an energy, will come up to here and will push the positive charges of the p-type material forward. Simultaneously, you can see from here negative charges starts. They will go. Battery is having energy, therefore that is dominating. It will push this negative charges forward towards the depletion layer or the barrier potential. So, when you supply sufficient potential, so the battery is connected. Why are you in need of a battery? It is to overcome the barrier potential. Overcome the barrier potential. As we have explained in the previous lesson, depending on if it is germanium, it is 0.3, if it is silicon, 0.7. So, though you connect a battery, if you don't give a voltage more than the barrier potential, charges won't flow. But if you give a battery and whose voltage is more than the barrier potential, if connected to overcome the barrier potential, then if you apply a voltage more than the barrier potential, then charges, that is both electrons and holes, get sufficient energy to overcome depletion layer, that is the middle region, and start passing in the device. That means the device becomes conducting. This kind of connecting a device is called something like a forward biased connection. So PN junction diode, if it is connected in a forward bias, it passes current. So if you say draw a circuit, draw a graph taking the voltage on x-axis and current on y-axis. When you apply a voltage, it's not that immediately current starts passing through the device. You shall apply a voltage that is more than the barrier potential for the current to increase. But till that, until the voltage is less than the barrier potential, though you apply the voltage, current has not generated because these charges have not got sufficient energy to overcome the potential barrier. Once if the applied voltage has crossed the barrier potential, then the current starts increasing like this, proportionately with the current. So even in a forward bias connection, that is connecting the positive plate of the battery to the p-type and the negative plate of the battery to n-type, current don't flow through the device immediately. The condition is the applied voltage, this is the applied voltage, shall be more than the minimum potential barrier potential. Thus, if you apply a potential more than the barrier potential, in forward bias, PN junction will pass the current through it. There is another way of connecting. That another way of connecting is called something like reverse biased connection. So by this time probably you understood what do you mean by reverse biased connection. So this way will change. We won't connect a positive plate to the p-type material, rather we connect a negative plate to the p-type material, and we connect a positive plate to the n-type material. So imagine this battery connection in this place. Now what happens if because of that? It's very much clearly visible that this negative charges, negative plate of the battery negative charges, comes up to here if it is connected in reverse bias, and they attract these positive charges back towards them. So what happens is in that case all these positive charges were actually pulled back. Similarly, from here, from the positive plate of the battery, from the positive plate of the battery, positive charges comes and they start attracting the negative charges of the holes of the n-type material. So they are also pulled back. So what happens because of that is the depletion layer, the so-called depletion layer in the earlier case was compressed and decreased, but the depletion layer here increases. So in this case, the depletion layer is going to increase. As the depletion layer increases, it becomes further difficult for the charges to flow from one side to another side. So there is no flow of charges. No current flows in the circuit of a PN junction diode. So if you want a PN junction diode to pass the current, you shall connect it in forward bias but not in reverse bias. But we would like to stretch a little further and see what happens. So, okay, you have connected in reverse bias. If the applied voltage, that's the battery voltage, is increased further, so the depletion layer also further increases. But up to where this depletion layer can increase? This depletion layer is a place or else a space at the junction. At the best, it will increase and come up to certain distance. Beyond that, it cannot increase. It cannot definitely increase beyond the semiconducting device itself. So at somewhere, you keep on applying the voltage, depletion layer increases and finally reaches a maximum. means what? That depletion layer cannot increase further. That means that's the best or the most difficult job that the device can give for the electrons and holes to cross from one side to another side. Now it has got a limit. Great. If we apply voltage, sufficient voltage, of course that may be a big voltage, then the charges will be able to overcome the depletion layer and current flows. So if you try to draw a graph in reverse bias, this is the reverse bias graph. What we can notice is, you keep on increasing the voltage in the reverse way, current won't increase, no sign of current. But somewhere depletion layer has already reached its maximum, it cannot increase further. You have given a big voltage such that it is able to give enough energy for the charges to cross that big depletion layer. Then the charges starts passing, current increases abnormally. Why? All the charges have got enough energy because of the applied voltage. They don't need any further voltage. It happens at a particular voltage, and that voltage is called something like a breakdown voltage. Simply, the device barrier is broken down so that entire charges are starts passing, so the current is increasing without further increase of a voltage. This is the graph of a PN junction diode, characteristic graph of a or VA graph of a PN junction diode. What we can see theoretically is fine, but practically there is a problem. The problem is, this barrier potential is high actually. Barrier potential is practically high such that the device, that is the PN junction diode, cannot bear that much of the voltage, bear that big voltage, and it gets spoiled. It gets spoiled even before we get that breakdown region. So theoretically we can use the PN junction diode in the reverse bias too, provided apply a voltage more than a breakdown voltage, but practically we cannot do that because the device is not capable of bearing that much of the voltage. Therefore, even before you reach the breakdown voltage, the device will spoil itself, breakdown or ruins itself. That's it. So a PN junction diode has to be used in a forward bias. Thank you for watching. Keep coming back for more and more.